Didn't really start noticing it until it was maybe a mile south on 121 and started to notice mostly the crops were looking pretty thin. But definitely coming up the EROS access road, the crops along that were just shredded. There was nothing left of them.
On a Sunday afternoon in July of 1997, EROS was hit hard by a massive hailstorm. Stones the size of softballs dented, shattered, and crushed everything in their path. Afterward, employees came out to assess the millions of dollars of damage.
And the thing that really struck me right away as soon as I got out of the car was smelled like silage, fresh cut silage.
When I got out here though, you can hardly walk in the yard. The divots were so large from the hail. It's quite a mess. It was very extensive. It was like a war zone out here.
You could spot the damage to the satellite dishes, the one on the roof, the AVHR dish on the roof, and the DOMSAT dish out front.
You know, the branches were pretty well wiped out of all the trees.
There was a solar panel field, and that was completely destroyed.
Heating and cooling equipment up there was all damaged from the hail.
The atrium windows were gone, the skylights were gone, and so they were covered up with tarps.
Anybody who was out here that day, I think, pretty much sustained pretty catastrophic damage to their vehicles. So
I think a little bit of how lucky nobody was hurt. Nobody was outside, nobody was hurt, because softball-sized hail would have killed somebody, I think, pretty easily.
I had been called on Sunday to kind of been warned or told about all the damage that was out here. I just remember the anxiety or the anticipation. The antenna, it was installed, all the parts and pieces were in place. The antenna manufacturer were out here doing acceptance testing, so it hadn't been fully tested yet, but it was getting really close, I would say within just a few days. They counted hits or the dents on the antenna dish, and there was over 2,000. So it was obviously, when you saw it, it was very, very devastating. It was a major heart sink because of all the work that led up to that, and we were so close to having it ready to go.
When you get to the 2-inch size of hail, that's going to pretty much destroy vegetation. All you're left with are just stalks of corn or little stems of soybeans. Landsat can give us a better estimation of the spatial area that was affected by the hail. So if we can feed that information back to the Weather Service, this is the area where the severe damage actually occurred. They can look at what was predicted for those areas and learn and possibly adjust the models to better locate where the most significant damage will occur.